Specialized cells are cells with a specific function, and having a basic understanding of a few different ones is important for high school IGCSE biology. We will start with animal cells. This is a nerve cell. You probably come across this cell before. Its function is sending electrical signals to the brain from different parts of the body, and are one of the reasons you feel things. They are adapted for their job by being long and thin, allowing the signals to travel more quickly. The red blood cell transports oxygen around the body and is extremely well adapted for its job. It has no nucleus, which makes more room for oxygen, and fits perfectly into the capillaries, creating the shortest distance for the oxygen to diffuse into the body. The sperm cell has a tail that allows it to move, and its neck is packed with mitochondria to give it more energy for its long journey to the egg. Finally, the ciliated epithial cell is located in the trachea and is covered with cilia, tiny hairs that push dust, mucus, bacteria, or hair up the trachea to the back of the throat where they can be swallowed. You will also need to know some plant cells, such as the palisade cell. This is the stereotypical plant cell we all know and love, with its geometric shape that allows many to be packed in one area, chloroplast for photosynthesis, and large vacuole. It works together as a tissue for photosynthesis in leaves, all of which are specializations of the palisade cell. And the root hair cell absorbs water and nutrients from the soil. The hair that comes out of the cell is an extension of the cell that increases its surface area and makes the cell better at its job. So those are a few specialized cells you might need to know, but be sure to comment below if you want a video explaining more cells. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.